These are things that we did many, many years back. I found some of them already done before I joined the World Talent Federation. Some of the universities which are our members, because if you check now the website for Harvard, they'll tell you, we shall admit you even if you have low grades or no grades at all, as long as it can be explained. Harvard will pick a grade C candidate and leave out a grade A candidate, because the grade C candidate has other potentials. Anybody in this meeting today has a chance now to get to Boston, to Georgia State, to Cambridge, to Oxford, or any of the Ivy League universities through the direction of talent. So if I have a talent report, I put it in the International Database of Talent, where these universities are members. When they see your report and your abilities, they'll pick you, some with scholarships, some with partial scholarships, or if you are able to afford, why not? Or if you're sponsored by your government. This changes everything. You are going to hear today people with bachelor's degrees, master's degrees, doctorate degrees from some of the most reputable universities in the world without leaving this country. So nipigie makofi nimefanya kazi. Kitambo ungesikia mtu atamepata hiyo degree bila kubeba sanduku, kupanda ndege, kupigwa na baridi huko miaka mingi akwe mgonjwa, si ndio? Na ukiwa hapa, use your local context, you still get the same degree. Minimum requirements for all universities that we deal with before they become our members. Number one, they must accept that during their admission, a talent report is an alternative to grades. So if you have qualifications, okay, you could be admitted. But if you don't have qualifications, but your talent report confirms that you have a talent, hence a career in that area, you can be admitted. Number two, talent has no age. You know, when you talk talent, people think children. Adults do have talent coupled with experience and life achievement. In fact, for adults, we evaluate their life achievement and their experience. We get the prior credits, which get them exemptions, and therefore they take much shorter time and pay less to get the degree. You're going to win. You can see some of them here are like your parents. They are also benefiting because they also have talent. Number three, that university must be accredited in its own country by the government. But above all, it must be listed by UNESCO, because we work and get sponsored by UNESCO. If you didn't know, the highest recognizing body is UNESCO. So, all the degrees you get under talent-based learning, in which there is no written exam. When we undertake talent-based learning, learning is embedded in your talent. In other words, we'll give you tasks based on your talent. For example, the musicians, you'll find them in dry riverbeds, recorded their music. You'll find the sports people analyzing strikers, midfielders. You'll find people doing very deep. The people in the media industry are the new ones coming to us. You'll find them doing what they know best. Whatever we get from there, we compile it into a project. It is the project which shows what you can do, which is presented to the university for marking, hence your grading. That changes how we do things. So thank you very much, indeed. And for those graduating today, I will tell you one thing. It's not enough just for you to have that certificate. It is important for you, if you did not, to know who else you are in many other ways. No employer today is going to employ you because you have a qualification. I can tell you, all employers, if you read their language today, they're talking, they want to retain talent. Amanadanganya. Check it. Out of 1 million jobs, they say, that were qualified, they could only employ 50,000. What was lacking? Begin to think. If you're a parent, angalia vizuri, in your neighborhood, there are children of other people who went to University of Nairobi, which are the university, and they're back riding border-border in Fikiria zaidi. What miracle will yours do with that same degree that the previous children did not do? Thank you very much indeed and congratulations.
Thank you,